गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टूडेज टॉपिक इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ कंपनी। एज वी नो दैट अ कंपनी इज अ लीगल एंटिटी एंड सर्टेन लीगल प्रोसीजर्स फॉर इट्स फॉर्मेशन इज टू बी फॉलोड। द स्टेप्स फॉलोड फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ कंपनी आर, फर्स्ट वन इज प्रमोशन, सेकेंड वन इज रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड द थर्ड वन इज कमेंसमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस। सो फर्स्ट इज प्रमोशन। All the efforts made to establish a new business unit are collectively known as a promotion. First of all, an idea is born in the mind of an individual and then to convert that idea into reality, certain preliminary functions are performed and the person who performs these functions is known as a promoter. So, the stages of promotion are: first one is discovery of a new idea. So the promotion of a business starts with the discovery of a new idea. Idea came into the mind by observing the deficiency of some product in the market, or help can also be taken from some professional investors. Next one is detailed investigation. After doing preliminary investigation, a detailed investigation is carried out to find out the actual position. During this process, information is collected about the availability of raw material, cost of raw material, need of machinery, reason of sale of product, expected sale price, possibility of getting finance, and size of business. So a report is prepared after thorough scrutiny all about all these facts, which is called project report. Next is assembling different factors. After satisfying himself about the possibility of success of business, the promoter starts assembling different factors, like he has to make contracts with different persons regarding their appointments. He has to purchase buildings. For that, he has to enter into contracts. So, the contracts are related to the purchase of raw material, building and plant and machinery. Last one is financing the proposition. As we know, finance is the lifeblood of any form of business. So, before starting any kind of business, capital is required. So, for this purpose, financial planning is done. There are many sources from which finance can be raised. The person or the promoter select those sources of finance which the cost of which is less. So, as we know, the sources of finance are like issuing share capital, issuing debentures, taking loan from banks. So the person choose those sources of finance the cost of which is less. And second stage is registration stage. As we know that the registration of a company is mandatory, so promoters try to get the registration of company by submitting important documents with the registrar of a company. After getting registration certificate, a company is a separate legal entity is created regarding company. So for getting registration, the steps followed are: first one is preliminary activities. So before approaching registrar, the following preliminary activities are performed. First one is registered office. First of all, the promoters have to decide in which state the company's registered office will be located. The company will be registered in that state only in which its registered office is located. Next one is to decide the name of the company. So for deciding the name of the company, it should be confirmed from the registrar office whether the permission for the name can be granted or not. The name of the company will not resemble with any other name of the existing company or it must not be objectionable to the central government also. Next one is to get license under Industrial Development and Regulation Act 1951. So for the balanced development of the country, the government has passed various rules. So if business is of that nature, for the starting of which getting license is mandatory, then the application should be sent in a prescribed form to get such a license. Next is to make necessary appointments. So for the registration of a company, promoters are required to make contracts with various kinds of persons. Like they have to make contracts with underwriters, brokers, bankers, legal advisors, which are appointed, and the name of people who will be signing MOA are also decided. Next is to get the important documents prepared. For the registration of company, MOA and AOA are a must. So promoters will print all these documents. And the last one is sending application to the registrar. After completing the above formalities, the promoters of the company present an application to the registrar for the registration of a company. Next is documents to be filled with registrar. First one is MOA. MOA is the main document of every company. No company can be registered without MOA. MOA defines the object of the company. It defines the purpose of the company for which it is established. And it also specifies the scope of its activities, means the boundaries in which company can operate. Next one is Article of Association. In this document, the rules are mentioned for the fulfillment of its objective, means for achieving objective of the company. The company will follow certain kinds of rules, and those rules are mentioned in a memorandum article of association. If a company does not prepare its article of association, then it can accept table A as its article of association. Next is information about registered office. So the information about the place and situation of company's registered office is also sent to the registrar, and such information must be provided within 30 days of the registration. Next is list of directors. Persons who have agreed to work as directors of the company and the name of those individuals must be sent to the registrar. Written consent of directors. Along with the list of directors, their written consent must also be sent to the registrar. Next is undertaking regarding qualifications here. Along with the written consent of directors, another information is also sent in which promise is made by the director to take qualification shares and making payment of these shares. Qualification shares are those shares which are necessary to be purchased by directors of the company. Next is preliminary agreement with managerial personnel. If the company is managed by directors, managers and secretaries, then a copy of contract with all these parties must be filed with the registrar. Next is statutory declaration. At the time of registration of company, a statutory declaration is sent to registrar indicating that all the mandatory requirements have been completed by the company. Next is payment of prescribed fees. Along with the above documents, a prescribed fees is also sent to the registrar of companies, and this fees is submitted in the Government of India account which is held with the Reserve Bank of India. Next is कैपिटल सब्सक्रिप्शन. अ प्राइवेट कंपनी और ए पब्लिक कंपनी विच डज नॉट हैव इट्स कैपिटल शेयर कैपिटल कैन स्टार्ट बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज आफ्टर इट्स रजिस्ट्रेशन. बट दोज कंपनीज विच हैव शेयर कैपिटल कैन स्टार्ट बिजनेस ऑपरेशंस ओनली आफ्टर अप्लाइंग टू द जनरल पब्लिक फॉर द शेयर कैपिटल. सो द कंपनी फॉर रेजिंग शेयर कैपिटल द कंपनी इशूड प्रोस्पेक्टस टू द जनरल पब्लिक एंड वन कॉपी ऑफ सच प्रोस्पेक्टस मस्ट बी सेंड टू द रजिस्ट्रार एंड कंपनी मस्ट फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ मिनिमम सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर स्टार्टिंग इट्स बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज. मिनिमम सब्सक्रिप्शन मीन्स द कंपनी मस्ट रिसीव द मिनिमम रिक्वायर्ड मनी विच इज स्पेसिफाइड बाय कंपनीज एक्ट 2013 विच इज 90% एट प्रेजेंट. मीन्स इफ अ कंपनी शेयर्स इश्यूज टू द पब्लिक देन इट मस्ट रिसीव 90% ऑफ दैट कैपिटल फ्रॉम द पब्लिक. If the company is not able, if the company does not receive that minimum amount within 120 days of issuing prospectus, then he has to submit or refund all the amounts received from the public in the form of application form to the public. So it has to fulfill the requirement of minimum subscription. Next is commencement of business. A private company can commence its operations after getting registration. But for a company, public company, certificate of commencement is also required. So in case a public company has to comply with provisions of Section 11 of Companies Act 2013 to obtain a certificate of commencement of business. So in case of company issuing the prospectus, so in this, for the certificate of commencement, there are two situations. First one is in case of companies which issues the prospectus. So a public company having share capital and which invites public to subscribe to its shares cannot start any its business activities if it does not satisfy the following conditions. So the conditions are, firstly, it must receive the amount of minimum subscription within 120 days of issuing of prospectus. Second one is every director of the company has paid to it the value of each share. Means the qualification shares taken by the directors. And the directors has paid the amount of qualification shares. And the last one is there has been filed with the registrar a duly verified declaration by the directors that they have fulfilled the first and second conditions. Next is in case of companies not issuing the prospectus. So if a public company does not issue a prospectus, then a statement in lieu of prospectus must be presented to the registrar. Then every director must have paid in cash regarding their qualification share. And the last one is a declaration must be filed by the directors to the registrar regarding fulfillment of first and second condition. So these were the stages of formation of a company. And the next topic is main documents used in the formation of a company. So the documents used in company's formations are memorandum of association, article of association and prospectus. First one is memorandum of association. Memorandum of association is the most important document of the company. A company cannot be registered without it. In fact, memorandum of association is a
foundation stone on which a company form of organization is established. In memorandum of association, those conditions are specified on the basis of which a company is incorporated. The document works as a boundary wall for the company. Any act which is done beyond the limits of memorandum of association will be ultra vires act. And every person, it is assumed that every person transacting with the company has gone through the memorandum of association. So the contents or clause of memorandum of association are: first one is name clause. In name clause, name of the company is stated, means the company with which it is registered is given in name clause. The name of a company is necessary not only for its identification but also for a symbol of its personal existence. The name of the company must not be objectionable according to central government, and it must not be prohibited under Emblem and Names Act 1950. Means no word like emperor, imperial, king, queen can be used without the approval of a central government. And if it is a public company, then word limited will be used. And if it is a private company, then word private limited must be used with the name of company. Next is situation clause. In situation clause, the name of that state is mentioned in which registered office of the company is situated. By situation clause, it is decided whether the company is an Indian company or a foreign company. Generally, full address of the company is given in memorandum of association clause. But if it is not given, then the name and address of registered office of the company must be sent to registrar within 30 days of commencement of business. Next one is object clause. This is the most important clause of the memorandum of association. And in this clause, those objects are given for the attainment of which a company is formed. So the object clause is divided into two parts. First one is main object and second one is auxiliary objects. Main object: in this, the company has to state those objectives for the attainment of which a company will operate, and those objects which are helpful and related and identical to the main object are also stated. Second one is auxiliary object. Auxiliary objects are those objects, if the need arises for the attainment of main object, these objectives will be achieved by the company, or the company will follow those objects. And the object of company must not be immoral, it must not be illegal, and it must not be against the public interest. Next is liability clause. Next is liability clause. In liability clause, it is mentioned whether the liability of the member will be limited to the shares held by them or it will be limited to the guarantee taken by members. In case company is limited by shares, then the liability clause states that the liability of the shareholder will be limited to the extent of shares purchased by them. And in case of company limited by guarantee, limited liability clause will also specify the amount of guarantee which is taken by the shareholders. Next is capital clause. Capital clause specify the amount with which a company is registered or the amount which a company can raise throughout its lifetime. Or it must also specify the kind of shares to be issued by the company. Next is association and subscription clause. As we know that a company is an association of person. In this clause, person signing the MOA express their intention to establish the company. Next is Article of Association. Article of Association is the second most important document of a company. It must be prepared according to the Companies Act 2013 and according to Memorandum of Association. It is an assisting document to the MOA. A company cannot be registered without Article of Association. So it is mandatory to form Article of Association. If a company does not create Article of Association, then it can follow Table A as its article. In Article of Association, all those rules, regulations are specified which are helpful for the attainment of its objective or which will be followed while conducting business activities. So the points mentioned in Article of Association are: division of various types of shares and rights available to shareholders, modes of rectification of preliminary contracts. Preliminary contracts are those contracts which are formed by the company, which are entered into by the promoters before the formation of a company. Modes of issue and allotment of shares, fixation of minimum subscription. Minimum subscription means the minimum amount of capital which will be required for the formation of a company. Rules regarding meeting of a company. Quorum means minimum number of members which must be present to form a legal meeting. Capitalization of profit, distribution of profit, various rights of members. These are the points which are mentioned in the Article of Association. Next is prospectus. It refers to that document in which all the information regarding company is given, like what is the objective of the company, who are the promoters of the company, who are the directors of the company. Such kind of information is given in the prospectus. So the following details must be provided in the prospectus. First one is main object of the company and signatories of the MOA. So the main object of the company, its name and address, and also the signatories of memorandum must be given in the prospectus. Next is share capital. It must also specify, it must be mentioned in the prospectus that what kind of shares will be issued by the company and what is the authorized share capital of the company, and share value of each shares and number of shares must also be mentioned in the prospectus. Next is managerial personnel. If the company will be managed by managerial directors, then name and address of those persons must be mentioned. Minimum subscription. That amount in the opinion of director which is necessary to be collected before the commencement of a business. Application and allotment money. Money payable at the time of application and allotment on share will be stated. If any prospectus have been issued in the last 2 years, then the particulars of the subscribed and allotted shares must also be given. Next, share or debenture issued for consideration other than cash. Sometimes companies acquire assets from other person instead of giving cash to those persons. Companies issued shares and debentures to those vendors. So the number of shares or debenture issued to those persons must be given. Next is share premium. If the shares are issued at premium, then what is the amount of premium charged from the shareholders? Underwriters, if persons have taken any kind of guarantee regarding issue of shares, then the name of those underwriters must be given, and the amount of guarantee taken by those underwriters must be mentioned. Preliminary expenses, the amount, estimated amount of preliminary expenses, and the name of those persons who have incurred those expenses must be mentioned. Who are the promoters of the company, who are the auditors of the companies, and time and place of inspection, modes of winding up of company, these such kind of information must be provided in prospectus. Next is statement in lieu of prospectus. Sometimes company do not issue prospectus, but a company cannot be started or registered if it does not submit its prospectus. But a company which is not issuing prospectus can be registered by submitting a statement which is like prospectus. It will be treated as statement in lieu of a prospectus. Thank you, students.